Yeah, Gemma was finally released by Google. Gemma comes in two sizes. These are 2B version of CPU and 7B version for GPU and TPU. You can also use instruction tune variants of both versions. This is good news, right? These four new LLM models are based on Gemini. Looking at the LLM dashboard, Gemma 7B ranked second behind LLM 270B with 63 scores. This means that it beat Mistral 7B. When Gemma is compared with other popular models for various NLP tasks, you can see that it surpasses these models. Here the green color refers to the Gemma model. As you can see from this graph, Google's model is better at all tasks. This is awesome. In this video, we'll cover how to use the Gemma model with Hugging Face. To show this, we'll utilize the 2B instruction version of the Gemma model. Let's get started. To write our code, we'll leverage Colab. First in first, let me set GPU. To do this, we're gonna click connect and then select change runtime type. After that, press T for GPU and click save. Our Colab is ready. To work with Gemma, we're gonna use the Transformers library. Let's start with loading this library. Pip install dash quiet and then to update, let's write U. After that, Transformers equal 4.380 dash dash upgrade. Okay, the Transformers is ready to use. To utilize these libraries, don't forget to set your Hugging Face token here. Okay, let's load the auto tokenizer of Gemma. This allows us to tokenize our text. Let's import the auto tokenizer class from Transformers import auto tokenizer. After that, let's assign the model to a variable. Let's say model equals Google Gemma 2B instruction. It's time to load the tokenizer. To do this, let's say tokenizer equals auto tokenizer. Let's call the from pretrain method. Let's pass the model. Let me run this cell. As you can see, the tokenizer started loading. Nice, our tokenizer is ready. The simplest way to work with a large model is to use a pipeline. Let's import the pipeline from Transformers import pipeline. Let's initialize an object from this pipeline. Pipeline equals pipeline. First, let's specify the task. Text generation. Next, let's set our model. Model equals model. After that, let's define our arguments. Model quarks. All the Gemma models are available for use with PyTorch. For data type, we're gonna use bflood 16. This helps the model run faster on your computer. Let's set torch d type. Let's write torch.bflood 16. To use this data type, let's import torch. Finally, let's set GPU. Device equals CUDA. Let me run this cell. As you can see, the model started loading. Awesome! Our pipeline is ready. Now, let's create our message variable. Let's say messages equals square brackets and then curly brackets. First, let's set the user role. Role. Let's type user. Next, let's create a content. Content. As text, let's write tell me a joke about Elon Musk. Cool! Our message is ready to use. What we're gonna do now is create our prompt. To do this, we're gonna use The apply chat template method. Let's write prompt equals pipeline tokenizer. Let's call the apply chat template. Apply chat template. Let's pass our messages variable. Messages. For now, we don't tokenize our messages. Instead, we just generate a prompt. Tokenize false. Lastly, we want to add the tokens that indicate the start of a bot response. Add generation prompt equals true. Awesome! Our prompt is ready to go. Let me take a look at this prompt. Print prompt. Here is our prompt. You can also see the prompt format for Gemma. Edit model token. We set the add generation prompt parameter. We easily created our prompt, right? Everything is ready to create a response. To do this, all we need is to use our pipeline. Let me show this. Let's say output equals, let's call pipeline. First, let's pass our prompt. Prompt. Next, let's specify the maximum number of tokens. Max new tokens. This can be 256. After that, let's want to add special tokens. Add special tokens. Let's set true. Let's set the doSample parameter. DoSample equals true. This parameter allows you to sample the next token from the distribution over the vocabulary. Next, let's set the temperature parameter. Temperature equals, let's set 0.7. After that, let's define the top tokens to create a new text. Top key equals, let's set 50. Finally, let's define the top p parameter. Top p equals 0.95. This parameter adds tokens in the sample for more probability. Nice! Our pipeline is ready. Let me run this cell. Awesome! The response is ready to see. Let me show this response. Print. Let's set the first element. Output. Let's pass 0. After that, let's select generated text. Let's want to see the text after the length of our prompt. Len prompt. Here you go. Here you can see the response. What do you call Elon Musk electric car? A Tesla mind. It's simple to work with Gemma using transformers, right? Yeah, that's it. In this video, we've seen Google's Neve's Gemma model and explore how to use this model with Hugging Face. I hope you enjoy it. Thanks for watching. The link to this notebook is in the description. Don't forget to subscribe, like the video, and leave a comment. See you in the next video. Bye for now.